I wasn't able to get his hooves ever. Today they're clean.
Yeah. Oh, you mean kick them out?
No. Well, I had the first time I got to him was real good, and then the next ones, every time I did it, he would fuss and throw his foot, and he even stepped on me once. I didn't get my foot all the way in time, and we couldn't, you know, scrub his just a soft brush and some water. He wouldn't let us.
But on his hooves.
Yeah. I like to just clean the hooves and make them look nice on the outside and inside, you know, both, yeah. That way I could see for cracks or anything weird going on.
Yeah.
And he's doing really well for you. I think it just, I have to be more of a confident person with him and do the cues that you're doing.
Well, like, and with his face, a lot of horses don't like being, being washed on their face or the hose in their face, but the trick to that is getting it on a pretty light, you know, not a lot of pressure, and make sure you're really close.
Okay.
And then, you know, as soon as he kind of puts his head down or maybe does some sort of relaxing thing, like right now he's just being real tight, I'll make him walk towards it too, and then I'll take it off. Because if they walk towards something, they're not worried about it.
Okay.
So if you make them walk towards it, it's another way to kind of
relax them or whatnot.
Yeah, and as long as you were like there, he was just walking away from it. So
yeah, that's what he did with us, was to walk away or he'd start stomping.
Yeah, he's got his head up right now and I'm waiting for something like there.
And then release.
He kind of put his head down and wasn't pulling on it anymore, so I just took it away.
Okay.
But you always go back. You know, I mean, even if you take it off when they're scared or worried, as long as you go back to it and keep doing it, it's okay.
Okay.
When you get in trouble is if you take the pressure away when they're scared or worried or doing the wrong thing and you don't go back to it.
Yeah.
And wait till they do the right thing. And
that's
when they learn bad habits.
Yeah.
So.
Look at that pink nose.
But he did good. Did you guys want to let him dry and then, or I could put him away if you guys wanted to leave. It's good to let him dry. He's got food in there, so we probably won't roll, but it's good to let him dry so they don't try to roll, because if he rolls in there, he might get stuck. Yeah.
And also, they've been afraid to take him out. They would put him in there and he charged somebody. So,
Well, you know, I remember you saying you wanted to move him back out there, and I think once Melissa gets here, you guys can sort that out if you want. But, I mean, I don't know. Tracy's the only one that ever really takes him out, and
it was that lady that has the Abby.
Oh, it was.
Oh. Yeah, he charged her because she put him in the corral to clean his pen, and she was like freaked out, wanting me to move him.
She said he wasn't happy in there, and that he preferred being next to her horses.
Well, I think as long as he's getting out every day,
he'll be a lot calmer.
Okay. Yeah, he'll be better. I don't see any of that happening.
Hopefully she'll just tell somebody else to do it.
Yeah, you know,
hopefully
I mean,
he didn't do that destruction. I don't remember it being that way.
Oh, I don't know. Lots of the horses, they step on it. And, the horse that we had in training was the one that put all the holes, said they had the patch.
Oh, my dear.
Right through him. He was bad. He was really, really bad. So I'll let him dry, and then I'll put him away once he's dry so that he can just finish his breakfast when it's all dry.
Here's your assessment, B. And what do you suggest him? Thank you very much. What do you suggest for the future for him?
You mean as far as me continuing or if you
Or
you
if
guys
I just need to desensitize like you were doing and well, first lunge him, bring it on him?
Yeah. You know, I mean, I don't...
Pretty good. I guess it would be hard to say without me just getting on him fresh, because once I've done all that stuff with him, he's going to be good. But I guess the real test is to see how he acts if you just get him out of the pen, saddle him up to the rail, or tie him up to the rail and saddle him and get on. So I'm not there yet. It'll probably take a couple more times to find that out. But if you want to just, if you want to keep doing the route, the only thing that sucks about that is you want a horse that you can just get out, tie up to the rail and get on, right, and be confident that he's not going to be silly, and you don't want to have to round pin, especially in the summertime, you don't have to want to round pin him for 20, 30 minutes before you get on him, you know. And then when you, but do some horses need that? Wherever you go, you lunge him for a bit. Maybe some hotter, like some hotter blooded horses. Maybe,
yeah, like Arabian.
But I don't, I mean, he's pretty lazy. As far as when you first get him in the round pen, I mean, he may just be tired from the past couple of days.
Yeah, we've been working him every day.
Yeah, but I mean,
but maybe that's the key to him. Just wear him out and he's better. Right,
yeah,
now, anyway.
Or they can learn to, they can get really kind of pissy, because if you wear them out too much and then you get on them and they start asking them to do stuff, that, you know, it's just like when you're wore out,
yeah,
and you're like,
I want to sit down.
Quit. Yeah, just leave me alone, you know. And so sometimes the horses are better for you if you can just get on them, ride them around, and they're good for you, and then you put them up. And
so what do you suggest with Fox? Does he need somebody that's better suited for him?
Well, why don't I put two more rides on him,
okay,
and by, I'll, on, so we'll ride him tomorrow and then Monday, and Monday I'll just get him out of his stall and get on him and see how he does, and then I can tell you how I feel, you know, what I feel, because I can take any one of these horses here and make them behave, but it's a different... But that's what I do for a living.
Yeah, yeah.
So I don't think he's that bad of a horse. You know, he hasn't done anything that makes me think that he's not trustworthy for, you know, a more novice rider. But I don't know if that's fair on my part to say that, because I don't know, it's been so long since I've been riding since I was five, so I don't really have any fears about horses, and I kind of forget that people do, you know, that...
Well, my fear was, and it's in my mind, is my whole neck is damaged, and,
yeah, and you
when
don't
he
want...
did his behavior, the saddle was minimal, and I got lurched to the left, and my brain was, I'm going to hit that rail with my head, and...
Yeah.
It's going to be bad. So part of that was me and my fear, and I need to overcome that because I want to ride.
Mm-hmm.
And number two, I got my saddle. It's, you know, excellent, so I don't have to fear. I don't have a horn, or it's not going to hold me that well. I feel a nice saddle. So just me eliminating and then him and I bonding, you know, we got some journey to do.
Yeah.
But if you... Especially after those other ones, you don't see any quirks. I think we're good to go. I just
yeah, I think he's safe.
Desensitize him on
yeah.
his head and his butt.
Yeah. Yeah, I didn't, like, I was patting him on his butt and all that, and he never even twitched or nothing. I think stuff around his head is probably what you're going to...
And that eye, maybe it was that deer he saw that eye didn't like, or who knows? Who knows what's going on?
Yeah.
Yeah, we'd have to experience it for ourselves.
Yeah, I don't know.
Well, she said she even got an experienced one on him.
Yeah, that's
so.
Right. Yeah, she said she got an experienced rider on him, and he went quirky on her.
Yeah.
But he didn't with you. He's doing good. So, yeah, a couple more assessments and see if there's anything that pops out and just go from there. That sounds wonderful.
Yeah.
Excellent.
I had an earwig on my leg. And it was under my pant leg.
And it's gone now?
Yeah.
Okay.
I flicked it off.
So I'll ride him tomorrow and Monday. And just give you the whole...
we'll be here every day too.
Okay. Yeah, so then I'll wait till you're here.
We'll come in the morning because it's 100 degrees every day.
Yeah.
Okay, so we'll see you tomorrow around 9 then. Great.
Sounds good.
Thank you very much.